Hello people, welcome to this video. Let's see together Adobe Premiere Elements 14 and all you need to start with it. Leave us feedback to improve us. Premiere Elements is a video editing software used to create, edit and improve your videos. Let's see all the basic steps you need to start with it. When you open it, a welcome screen appears. Here, you can choose between the three Adobe Elements softwares: Photo Editor, which is Photoshop Elements, Organizer, which is Adobe Organizer, and Video Editor, which is Premiere Elements. If you want to know more about Photoshop Elements or Organizer, check out our respective guides in our channel. Premiere Elements is composed by four different workspaces: eLive is used to get in touch with Adobe, with videos, tutorials, tips, and news. The other workspaces, from quick to expert, are used to work with your video project in different ways. The quick and the guided workspaces work together and use a simplified storyboard view. The expert workspace is the most professional one that works with tracks and timelines instead. Premiere Elements starts from a blank new project by default. If you ever need to open existing projects, just go to File and then to Open Project. Let's start from the Quick workspace. First of all, you do need to add your media files inside Premiere Elements. Just go to Add Media in the top left corner. You can import in different ways, from Elements Organizer, any device, camera or a direct webcam. To import files from your computer, just click and drag this directly on the storyboard. You can import videos, pictures and audio files inside. The storyboard view is composed by four different rows called tracks. The text track on top contains text and titles. Below, the video track collects videos and pictures. And two audio tracks, more below, contain audio speech and soundtracks. The storyboard concept is very simple. Your files imported, shown as rectangles called clips, are always placed in sequence, one after the other. If you want to change their order in time, just click and drag a clip on the left or right. If you need to zoom in and out, just drag from the zoom bar on the extreme right. Managing clips is very simple. To cut, copy, paste or delete, just right-click on a clip. To trim the clip, in order to remove parts you don't like, just click and drag from the clip's edges when you see your pointer changing shape. Trimmed clips always show this icon in a corner. If you have a mistake, undo pressing Ctrl and Z. To split a clip in two, fix the red playhead by clicking on the gray strip line above and click on its scissors icon. The two pieces will become completely independent clips. You can also render gaps between two clips. Gaps in the video tracks are simple black screens, while in audio tracks are simply silent. To create gaps, simply drag a clip as far as you need from the others. The gap will be always indicated through blue contours. To preview your project and its clips, use the preview on top. Use the player below to playback and stop. The preview will show all the clips that are under the red playhead at that moment. If you click and drag it, you can check your project in progress frame by frame. You can also adjust clips from the preview. Click on a clip to select it. If you click on the preview, some nodes will appear. Drag these to scale the clip. And click and drag to move it. If you want to adjust a clip in order to improve it, just select it and click on Adjust on the extreme right. You have two kinds of adjustments, color and sound adjustments. The color ones are applied on pictures and video frames, while the sound ones on audio and voice clips. Video clips that have frames and sound will have all adjustments available in the list. The first three tools are able to adjust your clip auto in order to correct brightness and contrast, reduce shakes, and enhance colors. The other tools are manual and more detailed. Use color and temperature and tint to adjust the colors of the clip. You can select any ready template you see or click on More to apply precise settings. Click on Reset on the left to undo. Lighting corrects brightness and contrast. Volume adjusts the volume of the clip, while Balance regulates balance between the left and the right channels of a stereo sound. In Applied Adjustments, you also have an eye that enables or disables the adjustment applied. An adjusted clip will show the adjustment icon in a corner. If you want to apply adjustments on an entire project, click on Entire Movie on top. Titles and text is used to add text inside your project. Here you have different ready templates. Just click and drag one on the text track. Select General under the Classic Titles category if you want to add simple basic text. Then, if you go to Adjust on the extreme left, you can adjust the font style, size, color and alignment. This will be applied on the whole text, unless you select a piece of it from the preview. Plus, while holding Ctrl down, you can click and drag to move, drag the nodes to scale, or drag from outside to rotate the text. Let's see now how to apply transitions and effects. Transitions are special effects that make a clip appear or disappear. In the bottom right corner, inside Transitions, you have all the list of transitions available inside the Premiere Elements. Just click and drag one and drop it in between of two clips, or before or after a single clip. Once you drop it, a small window appears in order to adjust the transition settings. Decide to apply it on the left clip, between the two clips, or on the right clip only, and its complete duration. The transition will be represented through its related icon on the clips. Double-click on it to adjust its settings again. You can also add effects to clips. By default, each clip has two effects added by default, motion and opacity. You can check all effects applied to a clip going to Applied Effects under Adjust. Motion adjusts the clip position, its size and angle of rotation. Opacity adjusts the clip's transparency instead. If you want to add more special effects, just click and drag an effect from Effects in the bottom right corner. This will be added in the list of effects of such clip, with all its settings inside. Clips with these extra effects will show an FX icon in a corner. On the right of each effect, you have some important buttons. The first one enables or disables the interested effect. The second one resets all. The third one removes the effect from the list. This is disabled for the motion and the opacity effects. Premiere also offers samples you can use through music and graphics at the bottom. Plus, inside Tools, you can apply advanced effects like motion tracking or save snapshots from your video with freeze frame. Use Pan and Zoom to zoom and pan inside the video clip itself. If you ever need more help, check out the Guided tab above. This will act directly on the Quick Workspace, highlighting all the single steps you need to follow to reach the final result. The Quick Workspace is very simple, but it may be not enough complete when projects start to be complex. In these cases, you will switch to the Expert Workspace, passing from a storyboard view to a full track view. While the storyboard view shows a unique video track, the expert one shows more couples of video plus audio tracks. Video tracks welcome pictures, videos and text, and audio everything that can be heard. This structure lets you place overlapping clips in time, but the basic functionality, such as how to add media, text or adjustments, is completely identical. Check out our older beginner guides to discover more about the expert workspace. Then, just save and render your project. To save your project, go to File and then to Save As. This will save your Premiere project as it is, in a .prel file format that you can open and edit later. If you want to obtain the final video, you can render it by going to Export and Share in the top right corner, deciding format, quality, resolution and the destination folder below. In case you want to render just a part of your project, just switch to the expert workspace and include in the work area just the part of the project you are interested. You can define the work area by dragging its edges. Thanks for watching. Check out our YouTube channel for more guides.